And welcome back. This is Pillars of Eternity. I'm the RPG chick. And I'm playing blind. And we gotta ask these villagers about the Lady Aelys who Lord Harand is looking for. No, I don't know. I guess we just ask random villagers? Maybe. Winfred's pleasant enough, but once you get him talking... Okay, maybe not. Not many new faces these days. Most are eager to leave Dyrford. Okay, do we not ask somebody? Or do we have to ask people... again? Pretty sure we talked to everyone by now.
Hello!
Okay, this is different. This is not ghosted out. Tell me about Lord Harand's daughter. He frowns and shrugs. Oh, I see that option now. His lordship says she went up and went missing the other day. He wipes a tankard with his ragged towel, twisting it with swift, jerking motions. I don't know any more on that. However, these lording bastards handle their affairs. Ain't no business of mine. Let's use perception first. I mean, I like to use my abilities if possible, so... I don't think we'd give him that much money. I mean, we have plenty, but... I like the idea of using our perception. You look agitated. Something about this doesn't sit right with you, does it? He slams the clean tankard down on the bar. Damn right it don't. That lord saunters in here like he's cut from cleaner cloth than the rest of us, and yet... He shakes his head. Look, I don't want no trouble from you or him or anybody else. I'm just waiting for him to tire of my ale and leave so things can get back to normal around here. Benevolent, that's new. I won't stand by and allow an innocent girl to come to harm. Help me find her. He leans on the bar and sighs. That girl, Aelys, she was looking to disappear. You should have seen her, watching the door like a sheep at slaughter. All the same, she didn't hardly speak to no one. Only folk I've seen her talk to is Trigil. Oh, Trigil. He nods at the east window. His shop's by the broken tower. Bit of a hothead, that one. My advice is to let the matter drop. Like I say, it don't profit to dig around in other people's business. I understand, Dangler. Farewell. Dangler explained that Aelys had become acquainted with Trigil, the local courier. His shop is one in the Broken Tower. Yeah, we've been there. Does Cid have anything to say?
Welcome.
No.
Got it.
Can I ask a couple more people before we go talk to Trigil? He's a hothead. I wouldn't be surprised if we end up in combat with him. This guy really wants us to...
Right, fetching feathers, lass.
Repeat, please, in Adirin. And stand closer so I can grab your neck if you said what I think you did.
That was Isselmere. She likes your feathers.
Thanks, but I'm not interested, Isselmere.
Awesome. I love the fact that he's got this other soul, this personality in him. These people have nothing to hide. Why won't they let us search? Maybe they do have something to hide. Let's check out Dyrford Mill. These people should be asleep. Just villagers, right? Right, we never had anyone we could talk to in here. Alright, never mind. Open that journal and take a look. Talk to the pig farmer, I guess. He's still standing out here. There he is.
Good day to you.
Any sign of the ogre? Or its head? Seen any signs of Aelys Harand? His hands curl into knobby fists. How many times do I have to repeat myself? I already told those snooping guards I haven't seen her, but that hasn't kept them from nosing around my property. Need something else? Nope. Let's go talk to old Winifred. Too bad hitting the fast speed doesn't make zones load quicker.
Well met, friend.
Welcome back. What can Winifred do for you? I'm looking for a young woman named Aelys. That lord's got you asking around, huh? At least you asked politely enough. Bad enough having a small army move into town, but then they start throwing their weight around and telling you your business. He shakes his head and clucks. That's the problem with these lords. They think their money and their family name entitle them some kind of special treatment. They expect everyone to fawn over them the way their servants do. No, sir. That's not the kind of people we are. Not in Dyrwood. We broke away from Adir to get away from that kind of nonsense. If they think... Focus. Okay, I'm going to try to be diplomatic here. I can certainly understand why you feel that way, but at the moment I'm just looking for his daughter. Of course. I was just getting to her. I haven't seen her. Not since she went missing, anyway. She mostly kept to herself. He shrugs and wipes at the buckler again. But you know how women are. Always carrying on. Full of palaver once any two of you get together. Perfectly harmless, mind you. I'm not criticizing. Just feels like you never run out of things to say. That girl seemed rather quiet, downright shy, if I do say so, but even Hedina got her talking. Just goes to show you. Hedina? An alchemist. Runs a small stand near the center of town. Talented lady, but she had a run-in with some worms not long ago. She's lucky it wasn't that ogre that's been roaming about. It took all of Rumbold's pigs the other day. Did you hear? But... don't get him started. He's still sore about the subject, and once you get him wound up about that ogre and his pigs, he won't stop talking. Yeah. Farewell. That's a person with a history we can't even talk to. Okay, so we've got two leads now. Hedina? And Trigil. We've got the Temple of Barath. In the interest of exploring all content possible, let me just go talk to Barath. Not Barath, but, you know. Whoever the guy's name is who officiates everything at the temple. Got a problem with those doors, they don't close all the way. Beadmar. The old priest nods politely. Is there anything else I can help you with? People in town say that the Hollowborn problem has been especially bad here. It has. Cities and villages all over the Dyrwood have seen Hollowborn, but Dyrwood hasn't seen the birth of an unaffected child in years. Most of our people have moved on to other villages in search of hope, and those who have stayed behind aren't the same. Children promise a future, you know. People change when you take that away from them. Speaking of children, have you seen Lord Haran's daughter? I'm afraid not. Lord Haran's men already asked me, and that was the first I'd seen of any of his party. He holds a hand to his heart. Wherever she is, in this life or another, I hope he takes comfort that her soul is with Barath. I think he's hoping it hasn't come to that. Just my thought on the matter. Alright, we'll talk to Hedina. I really only use the fast mode for traveling from place to place. I can actually turn it off now.
Welcome.
She adjusts one of her bandages. Anything else I can do for you? I've got some handy ointments if you're braving the roads anytime soon. Actually, I'm looking for a missing noblewoman. Oh, that lord's daughter? She was a new shade of green when I saw her the other morning. Chatting with Trigill, she was, just outside his shop. She points at the crumbling tower. Oh, I don't know. I wonder if she was pregnant. I don't see a reason to specifically ask that, though. What was wrong with her? She tugs at a bandage. No offense, but I hardly know you. I'm not one for gossip, and I certainly don't want to cause the poor girl any trouble. Lord Haran said she was ill from travel. She laughs. That weren't no road sickness. Trust me, I know it when I see it. Okay, you're talking about morning sickness. Was she pregnant? Now she'll tell her business. Aye, and worked into a state about it, she was. That girl was so sick she didn't even notice Trigill's stink. I offered her some herbs to take care of the problem. Thought it might save her some trouble with the old man, but she wouldn't have it. Thanks for the information.
Hello.
No, goodbye. And goodbye. Adina mentioned that Aelys was pregnant. Okay. Well, does he have something to do with the pregnancy? He smells bad. I mean, hopefully he's not the cause of it. We might be getting into trouble here. We'll see. I mean, if we have to fight him, we will. I just don't want to have the guards after us for attacking people in the town. Was Saban? Does he say anything? Oh, right. He's got the secret thing. I forgot all about that. Let's make sure we're all together and more or less of a good formation.
Eh?
He wipes a splotch of dye from his elbow with his shirt tail. Something else you need? What can you tell me about Aelys Harand? He shrugs. Only that her father's men have been banging down doors and stirring up trouble looking for her. I never met her myself. Which one? That's strange. Denkler told me you two were acquainted. He watches you and smiles slowly. He doesn't miss much. What exactly did he tell you? Just that you two are acquainted. His grin widens. That's one way of putting it. Oh, brother. Well, stop boasting now. Her father's dragged her out here to get hitched to some backwards noble. She wanted to escape, all right, and I was happy to give it to her. We snuck across the river a few nights ago for some private time. Come to find out, we weren't exactly alone. An ogre, taller than Winfrey's tails, sprung out of the forest, and we were so lost in the heat of the moment, we didn't notice it until it was upon us. I don't believe him. I think she's back there. It grabbed Aelys and disappeared in the night before I could even pull my britches up. Ugh. Yeah, I'm exactly thinking number four. I'm definitely choosing number four. Don't take this the wrong way, but this shop smells like an outhouse. Am I really to believe that a lord's daughter snuck into the woods with you? Trigill scowls. Curb that clever tongue of yours. I'm afraid there's no right way to take that, stranger. Just tell me what really happened. I don't repeat myself. Not for you, and not for some noble's toadies either. He wipes his dye-stained hands on his trousers and turns back to his work. dismiss us like that. At least fight us or something. While I had a hard time believing she snuck away with him, there may still be some clues in the wilderness. I can't ask him anymore. Kind of like the idea of looking for clues. I have a feeling she's back there, but let's look for clues. Why the hell not? See? Theodos agrees. The thing is, where? Which, I'm guessing, in an adjacent area to this? Or could we be back there? Oh, should we talk to that guy and send him the other way first? I'm not sure where in the village she is. Let me look for her first, since I'm all the way over here. Dyrford Crossing. Sure. I might find that ogre there anyway, if there is an ogre. Bright Hollow Lab construction completed. We've done a lot. Certainly done a lot. The rest of these are, as far as I can say. Yeah. Let's do the curio shop. Allows us to purchase the parts of exotic creatures and generates a random creature part every turn in the Stronghold Treasury. Only 2 days, so. Alright, so we're gonna start looking around for a little bit.
Margrin's fire casts light in dark places.
Sometimes it does, yes. Anyway, we're gonna do the normal thing and just look around. A wood beetle. Just completely look around everything here. I'm not sure how to get any of these. No. Yeah, that's the scripts. I want a macro to switch everyone to weapon 2. And back again. That should be easy to implement. Someone must have brought that up. So we'll get to see some of the new combat features. It's two wood beetles, apparently.
That's it!
Ooh. It spits corrode damage at us, what the hell? Alright, so let's do our normal. See that? You get to see the area of effect. Amplified thrust off of a deer. I'm gonna let us minor missiles. We'll just see him do the script. That's what I want to do with Adair. Ditto with Canna. And Palagina. I just want to see how they act.
Eh?
I've been poisoned!
Okay, well, I want her to attack. What's this? Another one? Come up out of the ground or something?
To alarm you.
Soul shock. Wood beetles. Arcane assault. That kind of thing. I don't think these are going to be that hard to defeat. Let's just have Durin's attack. Finish off this wood beetle.
But I'm just going to die.
Did he miss? Aelys. He'd hit for a little bit. Canna.
That's not very helpful.
I think I'm gonna turn off these scripts, I don't know.
What?
Beetle shell. Everyone seemed to be less responsive.
My eyes are peeled.
Than normal.
I shall be quiet as a calm sea, which is not very quiet.
And I turned on scouting, and they weren't scouting. They weren't sneaking. Not good. Okay, more beetle. Or at least a beetle. And once again, we're looking for clues of an ogre and or what's her name? Lord, what's his name's daughter? I can't remember names, my god. Barand? Lord Barand? Another smaller wood beetle back there.
It's
too bad. I feel like we almost have time to loose another volley, but they get close. Okay. Off of Canna this time. Amplified thrust. How does knockdown works on things like this? I think I switched everyone back already.
Poisoned.
Get over it. Soul shock off of Palagina. Arcane assault. One down. I'm turning this off. Yeah. I mean, maybe I should just make everyone aggressive. But I feel like, you know, if something's attacking them, they should just attack back. If someone's attacking that's right, we don't do it that way anymore. If someone's attacking a fellow teammate, So, just gonna have everyone just turning this off, making everyone aggressive so they react. See how that works. Kinda don't like it, I'm just used to, you know, doing it all myself. Yeah, good.
Be cautious. Be constant.
See that? Are we sneaking?
Yeah.
Oh, it's individual now.
Shh.
There you go. I have to select everyone. I have to get used to that. If you come across anything other than beetles. Pilgrim's Crown. Another friggin' beetle. They should just, you know, I know this is Dyrford Crossing and all, but it's Beetle Land. Just call it Beetle Land. Beetle Mania, you know, something like that. If that's the only one, we might just kill it with our missile weapons. But more than likely there's others nearby.
Yeah.
Yep, like that one. Oh, we didn't even kill it. It's almost dead, though. Normal strategies. If I thrust off of Kana. Shock. Will they automatically go and attack the rest of them? I think we're attacking. Alligator, turn around and kill this one.
Yes.
That's it!
That's it. Do we need to do lay on hands? See if it gets hurt too much more.
Yeah.
She's stuck. Oh, we can't get through here. Oh, she can run up here. Hit that one. Kill this one. And now this one. Is he reloading? I haven't seen him do that.
Helpful?
Is he just cleaning his weapon? Attack. Oh, that's right, I still have him with that. Duh. I don't think he can get through anyway. Kinda close with Palagina, but I was hoping we'd just defeat our enemies.
Of course.
Of course.
And what does the flame reveal?
Many, many beetles. Look how pretty the water is, wow. That looks like an improvement. I'm not sure if there's graphical improvements, but it looks like it to me. Dyrford Crossing. Can we cross here? Oh, apparently we can. Guess it's a chance to examine the lower part of the map. Apparently we've seen a beetle. A beetle? No way! Never thought we'd see one of those things. It's only been, what, a minute since the last one? I know. I am sarcastic as all get out.
Eh?
Eh.
That's not very helpful.
No, not really. Palagina. Stuck. Can you get around all this, Cam? I have to help him. At that. And now we can all attack that. We got some kind of ruin going on here. We got our raid out for this one, and it worked.
Nope.
Oh my god, another one. I just want to check out this ruin. Ooh. Got some chopped off legs going on here.
Problem.
Does it even see us?
I shall be quiet.
Yes. I was gonna call it an episode, but I do wanna explore this ruin. Beetle-free, if possible.
There's a calm sea, which is not very...
Shut up and attack the beetle.
That's not fair.
Nope. I agree, Aelys. Saving his spells, in case you haven't noticed. I tend to be conservative with things like that. If they're per encounter, then yeah, how about ya? Oh my god! What a just... Fall out of the ground and then go back in? Who's stuck? I dare us to go around. Get this one. Oh my god, there's more! Thank you. How about a bounding missile off of that guy? And a shield spell for, well, most of us.
Lavaru, be on the seat!
Unfortunately, Adair is now cut off from the group. He cast that and it didn't do much damage? One pierce damage, that's it? Oh wait, 3, 1... Does it resist or something? I mean, it's a very small amount of damage. Is it like, I don't know, maybe it just doesn't do a lot of damage on them. Maybe we need to try something else. Like a necrotic lance on this guy.
How many?
How about blessing? Effective. Necrotic lance is ineffective? I'm kind of confused by some of the stuff going on here. Let's just do arcane assault on these three.
That's not very helpful.
Not too long. Is she attacking Palagina? I'm not sure about this scripting stuff. I don't like it. Are we, like, not attacking when we should be? Mind wave on these things. They don't have minds. I don't know if it's going to work that well, but... I guess it worked. Amplified thrust again. See, he should automatically run forward and attack that one. Right? Is that silly to think that that should happen? Okay, look at these legs. You stand within what looks to be a ruined shrine. The moss-covered remnant of an ancient statue lies before you. Of course we're going to examine the statue. Only the broken legs and feet of the sculpture remain. Long grooves alongside it suggest that it could be moved. Near the base of the statue, you discover a skull carved into the stone. Examine the skull. A skull is cool. Carved into the stone in intricate relief, its mouth agape. Peering closely, you notice a rusty keyhole between its jaws. Pick the lock. After several attempts, you realize the rusted lock is behind the skill, or beyond the skill of both you and your companions. Push the statue. The pedestal appears to be several hundred pounds of solid stone. You consider who would be best to push it. Ask Aelys to push it. He's a big, strong guy. Although Kanna is very big, he's bigger. Let's try Aelys. Aelys pushes the statue, arms shaking and feet scrabbling for leverage. It doesn't budge. Oh, Aelys! Adair, I meant. Adair. Same thing. Kanna. I don't suppose anyone else could. Whoop. I meant to hit three. Interesting. Key. We need a key.
Hello. Hello?
Okay, it makes me laugh every time he does that. Anything else around? I don't want to find any more beetles right now. I just want to look at this. No, apparently not. Other than some flowers there. Alright. We've been running long enough. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And endure. In enduring, go strong.